It's all about you. Jesus, and all this is for you. For your glory and your fame, it's not about me. As if you should do things my way. You alone are God, and I surrender to your ways. Jesus, lover of my soul, all consuming fire is in your gaze. Jesus, I want you to know I will follow you all my days. For no one else in history belongs to you. Alpha and Omega, you have loved me, and I will share eternity with you.
I came to Glad Tidings in the early years of 1961-62 through the first pastor, Reverend Howard C. Osgood.
When I was a child, I stayed in Section 8 and GT had a story hour. And from there, I think I followed the Sunday school bus that comes around every weekend to pick us up for Sunday school.
After finishing my schooling, I came to work in Kuala Lumpur. I heard about Glad Tidings from the folks in Penang, so I started attending Glad Tidings since then.
A very small number, actually, it's only about 5 of us, plus a few new students from the Bible school. So about, I would say, in the early years, it was about maybe 10 or 11 of us.
Now I go to the part when I was a teenager, I think I stopped going to church as a child after a while. But as a teenager, I came when I was about home 3, and the Interschool Christ Ambassadors was doing very well. We met at BCM Chapel and it was jam-packed with students from various schools around that area.
There were a lot of missionaries around, and our pastor himself was a missionary. And in terms of numbers, I think it was around 100. Maybe slightly over 100 people.
Pastor Osgood, we call him Papa Osgood. He is so full of love and building us up spiritually. And we have what we call it a young people's meeting called Christ Ambassadors. And it was wonderful. Those are really powerful ministry touching our lives. Help us to stand firm for God.
Strong in Christ Ambassadors, which is services for young adults, then Sunday school, church services, and the Interschool Christ Ambassadors.
And also the youth, they were then called the Christ Ambassadors, a very active group, and I was very involved in that.
We were so charged with knowing the Word of God, and we do a lot of story hours in Section 8 as well as Old Town PJ. Through the story hours, they came to our church. We build up from there, and then later on we have ISCA, Junior ISCA, Enterprise Ambassadors, and the church start growing because of young people, school girls. On Friday they come to our chapel, they pack the whole chapel, and they enjoy the fellowship.
I attended Christ Ambassadors and I was very involved in this ministry, and it was then that I began to feel the call to the full-time full-time ministry. And one day I attended a service and the speaker spoke on giving our lives to full-time ministry, and I knew that I had to answer the call, and I came forward during the altar call and I answered the Lord that I will give my life to the ministry.
We were very active, we had a lot of funds, a lot of activities, and that's where I also met my wife.
I've always considered Glad Tidings as my home church, and there's no place like home.
This is the church I was baptized in. This is the church where I found my wife. This is the church where I got married. And also this is the church where four of my children were dedicated. And I see no other better reason to stay.
Why is it that, you know, I have to be in Sunday school? Why Papa and Mommy don't have to be in Sunday school? That triggered us to actually come into Glad Tidings.
Because I was staying nearby, and so was logical for me to come to church. It's just a few minutes walk from my home.
See, I came to the church in the early 1980s, when I was actually looking for a Pentecostal church, because I read one book, The Holy Spirit and You, and where I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. As far as I remember, we were actually worshipping in the BCM chapel. The congregation size was actually very small, probably about 100 to 200. I remember there were, prayer meetings. I remember there were what called women ministries, there were men ministries. I know there were also special what called cooking classes, you know, for the women. And I think those were some of there were children, definitely there were children ministry then as well.
Yes, also I went to ISCA, ISCA, it was for those in secondary school, lower secondary school, and we had a lot of fun playing games after ISCA meetings on Friday afternoons, and of course we were involved in Sunday school as well.
Yes, I guess no, it's probably linked to the death of my father. Pastor Johnny then was the pastor, and he conducted the funeral, and he asked me to give a testimony. You know, I was so shocked, I just didn't know what to speak. You know, I've never spoken in a funeral, I've never gotten a testimony in my life. And I also can remember that I taught many of my Sunday school children, students, and right now, in fact, some of them are actually church leaders, even in our present time. After a while, you get very close to the people, you get very close to the pastors and the leadership, and because I was very involved in serving, and hence, you know, I grew very attached to the church. I enjoyed the fellowship here, and so the pastoral care. At the same time, I was also involved in the cell ministry, and through the interaction of the cell members, encouragement, and also the motivation. And even as a cell leader, I'm truly blessed even by the cell members themselves.
Consider GT my home church, and it's near my house, so I'm a local boy, so it's, I think through thick and thin, I still feel very much at home.
Oh yes!
Came back in 1983 for my second holiday. The Lord told me to go to a church near my house.
When I came back from my studies in Australia in 1991, I was actually invited by a friend. stayed here ever since.
我来这边就会来这里，就是因为我介绍我一个旧同事，他的邀请，我才来到这边。
I think like to the thing I left. Sister Susie and the way the Sabbath at Tamil says, not a good thing, Karen, in particular.
Probably numbered about 600 or so. I was really impressed with the building. I loved this church building.
我来这间教会的时候，我们是在 BCM 的 教堂 礼堂 BCM 的礼堂那边，那时候的人数是 大概不超过70人，而且以上两年级的 姐妹居多。
The young people's group was growing, and I think that a lot of evangelistic efforts from this kind of the Disca, and we used to have a lot of young people's retreats. Quite a few leaders that came out of that group that basically came in the 80s, where you know, people were called into the cell ministry, called into the missions ministry.
When I came into the church, it was still a pretty much program-based church. We had men's ministries, women ministries, young adults ministries, Royal Rangers and ISKA and so on. And well, as a young adult, obviously, I was involved in young adults ministry.
大概就是主日学啊，就教导圣经啊，晚上有时候一个星期有一天的那个祷告会啊，就是这些。我印象最深刻的就是这间教会的会员跟牧师师母都非常肯愿意的帮助人，他们甚至可以牺牲他们的时间来到教导我们很多在圣经上的东西。
Christmas time
Well, I think it goes back to how God has first brought me to Glad Tidings. He told me in a very clear way that I should come to the church near my house, and since then the Lord has not called me away.
GTPJ ல இருக்கிறதுக்கு வந்து கர்த்தர் வந்து உண்மையிலே இந்த சபையில் அசைவாட்டுறாரு. இன்னொரு காரணம் என்ன ஒன்று, ஆண்டவர் அநேக ஆத்மாக்களை இந்த சபையில் கொண்டு வராரு, நல்ல காரியங்கள் செய்கிறாரு.
For a church that emphasizes evangelism and which also provides body ministry, I appreciate the teaching ministry of this church. And I see no reason why one should be looking around.
I will give you all my world. I came to this church because my sister is from this church. So I went through it, so I know this is my church.
I was actually on my way to FGA one day, and I was thinking that it was quite far away from where I was living, and I thought that I saw a church there, and I went into the church, Jalan Kasing.
Actually, at that time, when I first moved to PJA, I was staying in Section 10. So GTPJ was the nearest church. That's how I came to GTPJ.
I'm actually from an Anglican background. The reason I came to GT was because I got a job here as a secretary. After much persuasion from Sister Mary to attend one of the services, one Sunday I went to one of the services. And the worship was so fantastic. Since then on, I carried on attending.
建筑物都好似而家咁样。
GTPJ Tamil was nearly 15 people.
At that time, I remember there were only two services at that time. And it was quite full at that time. The ministries then, Junior Church, the Singles Ministry, outings.
At that time, we only have prayer meeting and sometimes we do house visiting.
The youth ministry was very much alive, it was growing, and junior church as well. It was one of the ministries where I joined.
因為我來到教會的時候沒多久有一個楊英成報道會然後有一些電影拍電影報道會所以我即是接觸這些會慢慢都吸引到我 Every day is special ever since we came to this church and every moment is a special moment.
It was in Red Tidings that I received my confirmation to go into full-time ministry in Bible College.
跟住當我有呢個教會繼續嗰陣時，即係我慢慢參與小組，喺小組即係組長嗰啲幫助啦，跟住教會都好多嗰啲慢慢漸漸有好多培訓課程啦，所以即係我覺得喺呢度可以即係慢慢去成長。I think overall people are pretty good, they encourage one another, the church itself, the movement as a body, that reconciles itself to achieve the mission, the function of our gospel.
Worship and the sermon, everything is here. It's very good and it's the best.
I feel at home in this church and I feel that I've really grown and I believe in the vision of this church. And I know there's a lot of areas we can grow in and a lot of areas where we can serve God in this church.
The church grow from a small congregation to this size, and even right now as we move on to another era, I believe that truly is an era of harvest.
And then if we could mobilize everyone to be involved in the activities of the church, then I can see that wonderful and bigger and greater things is going to be carried out in the church.
I see Grand Tidings as discipling people and sending them out to disciple nations. I see Grand Tidings as a great missionary church.
Well, if you keep focus, I think GT, I believe, was first planted by missionary. I believe that with our current strength missions, I'm sure God is going to continue to use Grand Tidings as a mission force.
God will really bless this church and bring more souls to this church.
I believe we will touch lives and reach nations and many souls will be saved.
As God has put different individuals in strategic places within the corporate world as well as within various ministries, parachurch groups, God is going to use these people and they, as they form the body of Blessed Tidings, will be a blessing to Malaysia and the regions beyond.
Impact our community in this Glen Valley, we can be an impact to our nation.
And I see GTPJ actually growing into a church of thousands. I believe that it is well within reach over the next few years as all of us continue to be faithful in our attendance, in our giving, in our respective ministries as we all put together.
GT is already very involved in missions. In different countries, and you can see that in the churches and in the future, there are a few of you that are mission food.
First of all, really, I believe
we
will
move into this land. God has great plans for our church, even to build.
The youth leaders today are training our youth to be cell leaders, cell assistant leaders. Worship service, so really doing a lot for the church.
Church that will touch the community, the PJ community as a whole.
I think that, you know, it's going to be awesome what God has in store for us, and I think it's something that even in the last college camp, as a new season, and it's going to be something that is really going to blow our mind away kind of thing.
I believe with all my heart, in the near future, GTPJ will send many into the missions field to plant thousands of churches all around
the world. The future of Glad Tidings is as bright as the promises of God. God is doing a new thing in Glad Tidings. It's bigger than we can ever imagine. The impact will be astounding. After 40 great years, we are now in the best position to fulfill God's mission for our church. To win souls, build people, impact communities, and reach nations. We are a dynamic local church with a national responsibility and a global vision. We will face many new challenges in the future. What does the Lord our God require of us? First, have faith in God. Second, walk humbly in all His ways. Third, attend great things for God. When we do all these things, the future is ours. By the grace of God and for the glory of God.